Good morning, student. In my last class, I discussed on the cells and organs related to immune system. Now, let us know about the types of immunity. The word immune comes from the Latin word immunus, which means free of burden. It refers to the general ability of a host to resist to a particular disease or diseases. Immunity signifies all those properties of the host which confer resistance to a specific infectious agent. Broadly speaking, different types of immune responses and immunity falls into two categories. Innate or non-adaptive or natural immunity. And the other is adaptive or acquired immunity. Now let us know about the innate immunity. It is naturally present by birth in an individual and is not acquired through previous contact with the pathogens. This is actually inherited resistance to infection and is concerned with species, races, or individual. The power of resistance to infection varies with different individuals of the same species and birth age also. Very young and elderly persons are more susceptible to microbial diseases than persons of other age group. Therefore, innate immunity refers to the inborn ability of the body to resist diseases that actually a species possesses and is genetically transmitted from our gene the next generation. As the innate immunity is concerned with species, races, and individuals, now let us know about species immunity. In species immunity, the diseases affecting one species does not affect the other species. For convenience, humans do not contract chicken cholera, while animals are not affected by gonorrhea, measles, etc. Racial immunity is that in which various races, that means various breeds, show marked differences in their resistance to certain infectious diseases. For example, black Africans affected by sickle cell anemia are resistant to malaria, while malaria affects other human species. Individual immunity, having the same racial background and opportunity for exposure. Some individual of the race experience fewer or less severe infections than other individuals of the same race. For example, children are more susceptible to diseases such as measles and chickenpox, while aged individuals are susceptible to other diseases like pneumonia, the naturally acquired immunity may be active or passive. So, let us know about the active immunity, natural active immunity. Naturally acquired active immunity occurs when an individual's immune system contacts an appropriate antigenic stimulus during normal daily activities. By producing antibodies and sensitized lymphocytes that inactivate or destroy the antigen. The immune produced may either be lifelong, for example, measles or chickenpox, or last for only few years. For example, tetanus. Now, let us know about the passive immunity, natural passive immunity. Naturally acquired passive immunity means transfer of antibodies from one host to another. For example, antibodies of a pregnant woman pass across the placenta to her fetus. If the mother is immune to disease like polio, the placental transfer renders the newborn immunity to polio. Certain other antibodies can pass through the first secretion called colostrum or the mammary glands. Naturally acquired passive immunity generally lasts for a short period, for a few weeks or months only. So what have we seen? The immunity, they are broadly innate and acquired immunity. Innate or natural immunity may be active or passive. Students, now let us know about the acquired immunity. Acquired immunity is not present by birth with an individual. This type of immunity is acquired during the lifetime of an individual as a result of previous infection. Specificity and memory are the two key features of adaptive immune response or acquired immunity. Mind it, specificity and memory, the two key features of acquired immunity. Acquired immunity may again falls into four types, such as active acquired immunity, humoral immunity, cell-mediated immunity, and passive immunity. Now, let us know about the active acquired immunity. Active acquired immunity is an adaptive resistance that is built up when an individual is immunized by a vaccine. A vaccine is nothing but a preparation of either killed microorganisms or inactivated microbial toxin. These are injected or administered to induce immunity artificially. Active acquired immunity develops very slow, in a manner of days. Active acquired immunity develops very slow, in a number of days and weeks. But persist for several years. Now, let us learn about humoral immunity. The term humor means a fluid, and humoral immunity refers to the molecule solution in the body. This type of immunological reaction is mediated directly against the microorganisms through the circulating blood, through the circulating blood proteins called antibodies. The antibodies are actively produced by beta lymphocytes or plasma against cell antigens of microorganisms and their products. These antibodies may induce resistance by blocking the infective capacity of microorganisms. By making microorganisms susceptible to phagocytic action, by neutralizing toxins or cellular enzymes, by killing bacteria or lysing with complements, or by combining with cellular antigens that interfere with phagocytosis. Now, let us learn about the cell-mediated immunity. It is a complex response requiring immunologically specific and non-specific features. This response may or may not be accompanied by humoral antibody, by humoral antibody formation, and the principal agent is an immunologically lymphoid cell, the T lymphocytes. These are specific circulating cells that recognize foreign materials and initiate a chain of reactions which include mononuclear inflammatory responses, cytotoxic destruction of invading cells, activation of phagocytic macrophages, and delayed hypersensitivity in tissues. Now, let us know about the basic immunity. Artificially acquired basic immunity develops against an infective agent induced by the administration of antibody against that agent. The antibody is produced and derived from host and is introduced into another host. Passive immunity lasts for a short time. usually a few weeks only. The antibody molecules, after entering into host constantly, break down without forming new ones. That is why this type of immune response shows immediately. So, we have learned that the immunity is broadly grouped into two: innate or natural immunity, acquired or adaptive immunity. Innate immunity may again be active or passive. Acquired immunity may again group into active acquired immunity, humoral immunity, cell-mediated immunity, and passive immunity. Okay, bye.